Welcome to the Old Bob Show. Located in beautiful Westby, amidst the scenic ridges and coulees of western Wisconsin. And now, here's your program host, Bob Burrell, along with his special guests.
Well, hello and welcome again to the Old Bob Show. And as we're taping here in the beautiful city of Westby at Vernon Communications, which is a sub, of course, of Vernon Telephone, the sun is shining and we have a possibility of warmer weather coming up. And of course, by the time you see this on YouTube, it'll be 2 or 3 weeks, but you'll be looking at us here in a week. And let's hope that we have really good weather going on from then on for the whole year. We need that after this incredible winter we've had. One of the nice things about Westby and Vernon County and Viroqua and Coon Valley, Chaseburg, Stoddard, all those wonderful cities here in Vernon County, western Vernon County, is we have an incredible sheriff's department, the Sheriff's Department of Vernon County. And one of the reasons for that, of course, is that the sheriff of Vernon County is Irish. And you know the Irish, they're always one step ahead of anybody who's thinking about trouble, because they're pretty good troublemakers themselves when they think about it. But I'm very happy to have today as my guest Sheriff John Spears. Sheriff Spears, thank you so much
good
for being
morning.
On board.
Good morning.
You look really sharp this morning, Sheriff.
Thank you. So and I dress up pretty well for an Irishman, right?
You really do.
There we go.
That's
I
right.
Like that.
But Irishmen always, they've got this wonderful smile, and they have the everybody knows an Irishman is a little rascal. So we all have a smile when we
That's
approach
right.
you as well.
It makes them wonder what we're thinking.
You have a lot to smile about this year, though.
Yes, we do.
How long have you been sheriff here?
I'm just ending my first term. This will be coming up on my fourth year as sheriff.
Fantastic. And, your hair hasn't turned much grayer?
No, it's been pretty good. I've been in law enforcement for over 30 years, so I think I've survived pretty well in Vernon County.
You have some challenges in Vernon County, even though we claim this is a wonderful county to live in. Today we're going to talk about some of the major issues in Vernon County as far as security is concerned and as far as the sheriff and his terrific staff are concerned. There also are some changes that impact upon the sheriff's duties. There's also a lot of really good events. And then there are awards. And then in the end, if you think you've done all right, as Sheriff John Spears has done, and you say, well, I think I'd like another try at this too. So we'll talk a little bit about the re-election that's going on here.
All right,
and why we should vote for you.
Okay, all right, thank you.
But how about some of these programs you've started while in office, like the active shooter training?
Yep, what we did with the active shooter program, there's been a lot of concern nationwide because of change in our society, and we've seen an increase again in violence with our schools and with active shooting in malls and in business places. And so we've taken a step further in Vernon County, where now we're going out and doing active shooter training. At first, we started with training our law enforcement officers. We've had countywide training where we've had open it up to all law enforcement in Vernon County and had them train at our area schools for responding to an active shooter situation, and we had a great turnout for that. The teamwork was phenomenal, and then we've added to it now where we're going out to the schools and providing training to the staff.
Wow.
We've done in-service training in Westby area schools and in DeSoto area schools so far, and the staff, the response we've had has been fantastic. It's a 4-hour training, and we talk about all the elements involved with active shooting.
Yeah, I'll tell you, that gives one a little more feeling of comfort because
yes.
we're all aware
yep.
of what's happening.
And even though law enforcement has a critical role to play in an active shooter, and so does the staff or the business people, it's like in our schools, it's the students that have the most important job of all. And what we've seen, we just did another drill the other day in a school. We do these lockdown drills where we come in and we assist them with it and we evaluate it after each one. And the speed and the timing that we're seeing from the school, it's been fantastic and reassuring that in the event where violence does erupt, they're going to be able to get locked down and secured and protect themselves very quickly. So
very much quicker, and because everyone's got a learning curve on this, and,
yes.
and the training helps.
Yeah.
Is this kind of an ongoing program throughout the states, or?
Yes, there's a lot of places that are picking up on it and doing the same thing. Like I said, we've tailored ours for Vernon County. Each time we do one, we seem to modify it and change it, which you have to. You have to modify it to the dynamics within your own community. And now we're expanding it because once we've done a few schools, we had a local daycare that said, we would like our staff trained.
Really?
So tonight we're going to be doing a training at a daycare center, and they've also invited a second daycare. So it's to provide that training to the staff to evaluate what they have available to them to protect themselves and the children.
Thank you, John. I'm talking with Sheriff John Spears of Vernon County, and he just outlined a fabulous training program, an active shooter training program for this whole area. And for all of those who don't live in Vernon County, you can tell your neighbors about it, or your own sheriffs, or your own police enforcement people. That's a great program. Now,
yes.
Active shooting, which refers to someone who walks in with a gun and wants to shoot someone.
Yep, yep.
That probably is influenced a little bit by drugs.
Yeah.
And so you've got a drug enforcement program as well here.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
And how does that work?
We have a drug investigation unit and a narcotics unit that works hand-in-hand with our tactical team. We're part of the MEG unit, the Metropolitan Enforcement Group, which is a five-county enforcement agency that coordinates the drug efforts in a five-county region. And we're having great success with that because we find these drug dealers are interconnected, as you recently seen on the news, local news, where some drug investigations that we were doing in Vernon County were also connected to La Crosse. And so they do cross the county lines and the borders once in a while. And right now we've been doing the full gamut of not just enforcement, but also education. You know, getting out there, having town hall meetings and talking to the citizens about what they can look for, how to respond, what help is available for them, especially when they have a loved one that's suffering from a drug addiction.
Right.
Because we deal with it on the law enforcement end, which is just one small portion of the drug problem. The devastation that a family or a community can see from a drug addiction in a family is terrible, because it's far more far-reaching than it is in just the enforcement end of it.
Absolutely, absolutely. How would you compare Vernon County to other counties in Wisconsin, for example, in terms of the drug incidents and as far as the police are concerned?
I'd say we're average. We're average, and obviously with our proximity to larger cities like La Crosse, that influences us, especially on our northern end, because there is that mobility factor there. And our society is more mobile today than ever. The drugs are transported most commonly by vehicle, and nowadays it's the culture has changed so much, because when we grew up, especially like myself, a big trip was going to La Crosse. When Dad said, we're going to La Crosse for the day, wow, that was a trip.
That's right.
Now, young kids, 16 years old, they get their license, they're going to Madison for concerts. Yeah. They're going all over. Nobody thinks anything of driving to La Crosse for supper now.
Yeah.
And the drugs transport just as easily.
That's right. And when we were young, of course, I was younger a longer time ago than you were.
I'm not going to comment.
But, no kidding. Drugs was a cigarette.
Yeah. Yeah.
Drugs or a cigarette. And the big deal was the manliness of a father towards his son who would try to sneak a cigarette.
Yeah.
Yep. And the response was, if you want to smoke, you smoke in front of me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, exactly.
Which, of course, the cigarette was, they really weren't roll your own, but they were pretty strong cigarettes.
Right.
So it's changed a lot. The culture has changed incredibly, as you said.
And the drugs have changed. Obviously now we're seeing the influx of heroin, which is a terribly addictive drug and a very powerful drug. And heroin, methamphetamine, the new drug crocodile, which we haven't seen anything of that in our area yet, but it's just a matter of time. We're constantly trying to play catch up with these drugs. And obviously in law enforcement, we're more reactive, to situations. So it's important, I feel, that we be proactive in every area we can.
Yeah, excellent, excellent, excellent program. You've got a wonderful staff, a lot of volunteers, I'm sure, who are helping in all of these good programs. And the nice thing about what you're doing is that you not only ask them to do the job and sometimes to risk their lives out there, but In the end of the day, you have some rewards for them, or some awards, I should say.
You bet.
And I'd like to have you identify for this area who are watching the three or four people that received awards this year for their work.
Sure, and we're very proud of them. We recently had Deputy Sheriff Larry Howell, who's been with the Sheriff's Office for about 30 years. He had a life-saving situation where he utilized the automatic defibrillator to help save a person's life, and he received recognition for that. And I nominated him for an award through the Stoddard American Legion. And he won their local award for Officer of the Year. And then after that, he moved on to the county level, where he was selected for the County Legion Law Enforcement Officer of the Year. And now he'll keep moving on to the district and then hopefully to state.
Wow,
so
wow.
That was a great recognition for Deputy Howell. Larry does a great job. And then we recently celebrated with the Viroqua Eagles Club.
Okay.
They do an annual event where they honor law enforcement, firefighters, and EMTs, and they give awards appropriately. I nominated Deputy Sheriff Adam Moline, who's one of our canine officers.
No, he's from Vernon County.
He's from Vernon County, lives in Stoddard.
Right.
Adam's been with us a couple years already, young officer, young deputy, but very energetic. One of those guys that always has a smile on his face. His demeanor is top-notch. And his partner, Mick, the canine, they do a great job for Vernon County. And so I nominated him for that. And the unique thing was, the night of the banquet, I was told that there were three nominations. Well, not only did I nominate Deputy Moline, but his sergeant, Sergeant Joel Zitzner, nominated him, as well as a fellow deputy, Phil Welch. So
fantastic.
Adam received three nominations for Law Enforcement Officer of the Year, and he did receive that award. And and Sherry Jacobson,
So now we've talked about the American Legion and the Eagles.
Yep.
These are community, really active community agencies, I should say, or organizations. You get an idea of the incredible cohesion, if you will, between the Sheriff's Department and all of these other good groups out there. Now, so that was Larry and Adam, but now we go to Sherry Jacobson.
Yes, part of the Eagles Awards were also for EMT of the Year. And Sherry Jacobson, who's been a great partner in law enforcement, her husband is Sergeant Charles Jacobson, who's a jail sergeant with our office.
All right. She
was nominated by several agencies for EMT of the Year. She's an instructor. She's trained and educated countless numbers of individuals in the EMT field and in first responders.
Wow.
And she received EMT of the Year, and it was very well deserving. And then a firefighter by the name of Ray Syme from the Viola Fire Department. I believe he's been on the fire department since like 1964.
Holy
and
cow.
He received Firefighter of the Year. And
wow.
Very humble man, but very well deserved. It was very impressive to listen to him talk, and I'm sure he would have a lot of stories to tell about the changes in the fire service. So
absolutely. And you know, it's nice to have a more of a seasoned person on there as well. It's good for all the people coming along behind him. Those are fantastic. Excuse me, fantastic awards, Sheriff. And it's pretty fantastic that the Sheriff's Department, like many other departments, single out people for their good work. It's inspiring for other people as well.
Absolutely.
And I think what it does is also engenders even more support from the communities because of the acquaintances and that sort of thing. Now, you mentioned earlier, was it Larry, a canine, who has a canine?
Adam Moline.
Has a canine. And this will have happened already, but let's talk about quickly the canine run-walk activity.
You bet.
Now, the canine run-walk activity is, again, part of, what would you say, it's kind of a subsidiary of the drug enforcement?
The canines are instrumental in our drug enforcement because they're dual-purpose canines. We have two, and both canines not only search out narcotics and drugs, but they're also trained in apprehension of fugitives and also officer protection. So, you know, they're utilized across the board. But to keep that canine program going, obviously it takes money and funds.
Sure.
And last year we did our first canine run walk, which was a 5K. And we had a great number of people that showed up and took part in it. We raised good money for the canine program. So this year will be our second annual one. It's going to be on April 5th, which will have already taken place. But Right now, I believe we have about 150 pre-registered runners or walkers for that event, and that's very humbling to me that to see that many people come out for a program like that to support our canine program. And
so, in order to be in a run walk, what's the contribution you make?
$20.
$20 for the run walk.
$25 the day of the event.
So there you got $150. That's $3,000.
Yep.
How'd you like that calculation there?
That's pretty good. You're Irish. See? I can tell. Yeah.
I'm a grade school boy, you know, grade school guy.
There you go. And no calculator was needed to do that.
Exactly. Thank you very much. I'm trying to get that back into school so they can do that sort of thing.
Good luck. That's good.
Okay, so that's the canine run walk, Sheriff. Then we have the drug talk back. Now that's a really interesting drug talk back. And what does that mean?
It's drug take back. No, it's a national take back day, and what it's designed to do is, again, talking about all the aspects of drugs. Prescription drugs is very, very dangerous. It when people abuse prescription drugs, or we see a lot of burglaries and thefts and other crimes that are associated around drugs, it's where people are breaking into homes, stealing those pain medications. So we have an annual drug take back day where people can bring prescription drugs into the sheriff's office, to other police agencies, and they'll have different locations around the county to turn those in so they can be properly disposed of, because we don't want people flushing them down their toilets, because it can go into the groundwater and affect all of
that's
us.
Right.
And again, this year, affect all the
angleworms and around like this. And there's no doubt about it. It's very serious.
Yes.
Yeah, all of that we didn't have really in our life at all, 20, 30 years ago?
No, not to the extent that we have it today.
Yeah, the problem is, as the sheriff pointed out earlier, is that there's such mobility, easy mobility, and transportation easiness, and from state to state, no problem. You can cross borders and come from Chicago into the area.
Absolutely.
Is Chicago, is that a mainstream feeder, or Minneapolis?
Yeah, Chicago, Minneapolis, a lot of it, or I should say a lot of, some of it's gang related, but a lot of it with the drugs, they move to the rural areas because they feel that the enforcement isn't either up to speed with what's going on, or we don't know the people, you know, and it takes time to develop these informants and develop drug cases against an individual, and it's tough.
Does Vernon County and the Sheriff's Department, do you have any kind of, what am I talking about, not a subsidy, but any grants from the state or from the Fed for these kinds of programs?
Very limited. The grant money for drug enforcement has been dropping considerably, and that's of a very big concern to us, because our MEG unit that we're involved with the five counties, survives on grant funds.
Sure.
And with those grants going away and getting lower each year, we're again in jeopardy of possibly that MEG unit being in jeopardy. And we rely on that as a small county. The MEG unit allows us to purchase equipment and different surveillance stuff for five counties, where one county wouldn't be able to do it, and we share that.
That'd be a
big push if we could get people to give us more grant money from the state and from the federal level to support those, because the drugs are in the rural areas and we need assistance with that.
You use the word the MEG unit, which refers to a coalition of five counties.
Yes.
And those counties are?
Vernon County, Monroe County, La Crosse County, Jackson County, and Trempealeau County.
Fantastic. You didn't have a whoops on that.
Nope.
But, you know, it's kind of like a corporate organization over your when you're together this helps you all to be communicating with each other,
and that's a good point, because that's huge, because again we find that if we're developing a drug case in Vernon County, we can, through the MEG unit, we can find out that they have connections to La Crosse County, Monroe County, Jackson County, sometimes all five counties, so we know what size of operation we're dealing
with. It slipped my mind. I had a whoops.
Okay.
We're talking to Sheriff John Spears, Sheriff of Vernon County, and appreciate very much your being here,
Thank you.
Sheriff.
Thank you.
The other thing, I know what it was all about. It's a very favorite subject, if you will, of my wife and my spouse, long-term helper, Jean, Raleigh Burl, who is a camera person and does a great job along with Randy Smalley here of helping produce this program. But she probably, if she had the choice between me and a really good thoroughbred Morgan horse, etc., she might hesitate.
It'd be a tough choice,
that's
maybe.
That's exactly,
huh?
Right.
Okay.
And we're talking about horses.
Yeah.
And you have a mounted trainer,
mounted patrol. Yeah.
Wow, it's like New York City.
Oh, you bet. Yeah. You bet. Yep.
So when did this come about?
About a year and a half ago, we started a mounted patrol with one of our part-time deputies, Deputy Jay Vasateg, who had a horse, Leon, and he approached me and wanted to talk about this. He went to the training himself, paid for the training himself.
Oh, I was going to ask if he had a training program to be a good rider.
He had to go. He had to go to, I'm not sure, I believe it was Arizona, to get the training. And his horse Leon is phenomenal. It's just such an amazing animal.
Leon's the horse.
Leon's the horse.
Yeah,
yes,
okay,
Leon's
good.
The horse. I had to be reminded of that one day because the only thing we spent on it was we did buy a badge that said Leon. And when my chief deputy, I walked into Chief Deputy Campbell's office one day, and there's a badge laying on his desk, and it said Leon. And I'm racking my brain going, who is Leon? Who did we hire that's a deputy named Leon? And then I remembered it was the horse.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
But we've utilized Leon and Jay.
Does he have a nose bag when for feeding and that?
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah, we've utilized him for the Vernon County Fair, for different parades, for some PR work. You'll normally see Leon and Deputy Vasateg over on the Kickapoo Valley Reserve.
Now listen, you're ending your first 4-year term.
Yes.
And obviously, you love your job, and you can see that as we're talking here.
Yeah.
So, you've thrown your hat into the ring again.
Yes.
And you will be campaigning, obviously, on this fantastic record you've got. But anything else you'd like to say about why you ought to be sheriff?
I really love my job. I guess the biggest thing I just want to relay is it's been my whole life. I think we talked on the first time I was
That's
on
right.
the old Bob Show.
Yep.
I grew up in a law enforcement family with my father, my wife, my sons are in law enforcement. I do love it. I enjoy going to work every day. I felt I feel that right now we've accomplished a lot in this first term with the staff that I have. We've got some super dedicated men and women in law enforcement in Vernon County. We're very fortunate to have them. We don't have the problems that we have in, or that we see in some other agencies, or sheriff's offices around the state. So with law enforcement, and I still have things I'd like to accomplish. I would like to do another term. So I talked it over with family, and I'm going to be seeking re-election. If the people will have me, I'd like to do another 4 years as sheriff of Vernon County.
Well, that would be wonderful. And maybe if you're elected, you can talk to Bruce Olson, who is the number one man in Crime Stoppers for you, right?
Yep, he's our Crime Stopper police coordinator.
Yeah, that's right. And I've tried to get Bruce on this program for 3-4 times, and I got a feeling he's bashful.
Well, now when he watches this, see, we've got him. Now he's going to know he's got to get
that's
in there.
Exactly
see.
Right. So, Bruce, wherever you are, I'm going to give you a call. And this time, you throw a lasso around the president of the Crime Stopper Foundation, is it?
Yep, Crime Stopper Board.
Yep. And we'll haul him in, and we look forward to seeing you on the show, Bruce. And this has been just a wonderful experience for me to be talking with Sheriff John Spears, and who is, been in the police culture all of his life, as he has said, and it fits. And if you lived in one of those Irish burgs, like in the New York boroughs, or so forth and so on, you'd be number one sheriff there as well.
Well, sure. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for
Thank
being
you.
With us.
Thank you.
And good luck to you and all your troops.
Thank you. And we'll be thinking spring now and warmer weather.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. And that means that there'll be a few people out there who will be out there with convertible. The tops down and maybe speeding a little bit, feeling the wonderful part of the spring. I mean, I would if I had a convertible, I know that. This has been wonderful to talk with Sheriff Spears, and we're looking forward again to the spring and the summer and to seeing him and all his fine people out there working in these wonderful activities. Don't forget, we have coming up the drug talk Back, Take Back Show, and that's April 20th, right?
Yep, 26th.
26th. April 26th, so you guys be on the lookout here in Western Wisconsin. I'm Bob Burrell for Old Boy, and I want to thank you again for being with us, and tell your friends and neighbors we're on the air here on Channel 14 in this Western area, 3:30 every afternoon, Monday through Friday, and 8 o'clock at night, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday night, and Saturday at 9:30 and Sunday at noon. So plenty of chances to have a good look at some of the people who are serving all of you. You guys all have a good week, have a good day. God bless all of you, and we'll see you again.
You've been watching The Old Bob Show on your community channel. Check your guide for other Old Bob programming and have a good day.